Good morning, friends. Coach Campbell here. It is May 19th, 2020. Let's begin in prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, let me play well but fairly. Let competition make me strong but never hostile. Forbid me to rejoice in the adversity of others. See me not when I am cheered, but when I bend down to help my opponent up. If I know victory, allow me to be happy. If I am denied, keep me from envy. Remind me that sports are just games. Help me to learn something that matters once the game is over. And if through athletics I set an example, let it be a good one. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, friends. So today we are talking about something that applies to all of my students. I teach preschool all the way up through eighth grade. And I want to share something with you that I learned that helps me out a little bit. And it comes from an interesting place. So my niece, her name is Teresa. She was in love with Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood growing up. And though it can be a little bit annoying sometimes, he has a lot of really great ideas. And one of his little sayings is, when you get so mad you want to roar, take a deep breath and count to four. And I personally use that phrase on a daily basis, not just with my children, also internally with myself, because most of the things that I have a desire to raise my voice about are not things that my voice needs to be raised about. So yes, stopping one child from hurting another child might warrant raising my voice, but when I'm frustrated because someone has asked me something for the sixth time, don't need to raise my voice. Try it. It may not work for you. You may think it's ridiculous, and that's okay. I notice that it makes me a little bit of a better person, and I am each day trying to grow in holiness and trying to be the person that God wants me to be. And if not yelling and controlling my personal emotions when I'm trying to teach my students and my children to do the same thing, it just seems to make sense to me. Not easy, but definitely worth it. So give it a try if you want. If you don't, I'll be here tomorrow with another idea. I love you guys. I hope you have a fantastic day. And I hope that you have some great adventures, maybe without yelling, especially in the house. Take care. Stay safe. Love you.